with Carl Brown, or the actress.
Hey, how you doing?
Absolutely wonderful. Tell us about your character.
Well, I played a villain in a movie. Character named Butcher Knife Brown.
Woo! So we know what you were doing.
Yeah, so it's pretty much, to be honest with you, it was great playing the character. I'm the boogeyman, the hitman, the bad guy in the movie. So I really enjoyed it.
Was it really different from how you usually are, or were you able to really allow the truth of yourself?
My basics is comedy, improv, doing a little singing, that kind of thing, kind of being cheerful, cheering people up kind of deal. But this was one of those things where who doesn't want to play a bad guy, like at least one time, you know, in their life?
Did you have to go into some really dark places to put it out?
Dark places as in...
You know, as far as
the character?
Maybe you're not a method actor, but you know, yeah, as far as character, what you have to think about.
I from time to time, I felt myself having to like kind of get alone to kind of get in what I would call the mode. Because me being a silly guy, joking a lot, joking around a lot, I had to get in the mean mode. So, and a lot of people backstage, excuse me, on the set were expecting me to be a little bit more cheerful, but I got to know them lines. And I had a lot of lines. I had to stay in character. So as soon as I just got there, it was like, whoop, study my lines, know what I got to see and I got to do and hit it.
Have you had a chance to watch the movie?
I have seen it. I have seen it just one time.
What was it like watching it?
I was so happy that it turned out good. Because like when you're filming everything, you're doing your part. You have your itinerary, where you're supposed to meet at, where you're supposed to go. And I might not necessarily see all these people that are in the film with me if I don't have scenes with them. Other people got romantic scenes with each other. I don't have romantic scenes.
Oh, boo, get in.
People are usually not that happy to see me.
Gotcha.
Very much so.
Do you have a funny story about something that happened on set?
Funny story. I got hurt a little bit.
That doesn't sound funny.
It was kind of funny to me, but it wasn't like...
How'd you get hurt?
I'm supposed to be like fake killing somebody.
Okay.
And they like shooting this fake blood everywhere and it's a little bit of it on the floor, and let's just say I'm supposed to be doing something, and I kind of tweaked, trying to be cool and tough, and kind of tweaked my groin a little bit, so I had to, I'm silly, so I thought it was funny. You're trying to be cool, you're trying to be mean, and...
Did they get it from the behind-the-scenes boomers?
Nobody knew it even happened.
I didn't
let it on, because the thing about filming is once you start filming, you try to get through.
Right, absolutely.
I mean, this is one of them days where we started shooting... like 7 to 8 in the morning. I'm like, I ain't got time to tell you I'm hurt and then start all over again. Right. We need to get through.
Nobody's bringing you ice cream?
Not at all. Especially not for the bad guy.
Well, I am so excited to watch this movie.
I am.
What would you like people to know about it?
Listen, this is one of the best independent films you're gonna see. We put a lot of work into it, and stay tuned on some other things that we're gonna be doing as well. But it's a good film. And I'm not just saying that because I'm in it. It's a good movie. Thank you very much for coming out and supporting us.
Well, there it is. We'll be right back. Thank you so much.